So, there are these two young fish swimming along. They meet this older fish coming the other way. "Morning, boys," the older fish says. "Water's cold today, isn't it?" And then he swims off. The two younger fish watch the older fish swim off, and then they turn to each other, completely baffled, and they go, "What the fuck is water?" David Foster Wallace told this story once. See, our water is called finance. You can't see it, can't smell it, and to most people, it's imperceptible. But we are the fish in the know. And that gives us a great advantage and a great responsibility. Yes, it does. Don't ever forget that. But if we're the fish in the know, then Massimo, he's the one who swims up behind you, and you don't even see him coming. He's the shark. You see, not one of us fish thought to short Greece. Not one, except Massimo Ruggiero.
They say the devil's greatest trick is making us think he doesn't exist. But he's real. As real as the water fish swim in. As real as the finance flowing through this bank. I've drunk his wine, laughed at his jokes. I have looked into his eyes and seen the terrifying blackness of my own soul reflected in his.
Let's get to work. Let's not lose money.
Ready, Maestro?
Oh, you go ahead. It'll be along in a minute.
They're coming, aren't you?
Even sharks got a kickback once in a while.
I'm coming, guys. I promise. How about a drink?
John's memorial service is Monday. I should get home to Nina. Can I have a word?
Yes.
You know how proud I am of you, how hard you work, how much you sacrifice. You deserve your success.
No one deserves this kind of success.
You really don't care about the money, do you? I think a part of you actually hates it.
If this is about the promotion...
I'm supporting you. And I have every expectation you'll get it.
But there is a problem. Edward Stewart.
Ed doesn't like you. He says he's not going to report to you if you're vice CEO.
Yes, because I didn't grow up drinking tea and playing cricket.
Yeah, he may be somewhat of a racist, but he's qualified, and he has supporters on the board.
You're asking if I'll report to Ed if he gets vice CEO instead of me.
Other banks will snap you up in a minute. I don't want to lose you.
I'm loyal, Dominic, you know that.
But you haven't answered the question. Massimo, how'd you notice short Greece? And don't tell me you read the reports, because everybody else read them too.
Instinct.
John lost his life in a firefight outside Basra nearly 3 years ago. No words can describe the grief a parent feels for the loss of a son. I speak for my wife, Nina, and myself when I say John's loss leaves a hole in our hearts we can never fill. But we are left with extreme pride. Pride that a young man chose sacrifice over self-interest. A young man born of privilege would forsake that to serve his country.
I can't bear it anymore. Can you take me home?
If you would indulge me, I would like to share some memories of our remarkable son.
Hey! Fire! Hey!
Let's talk on Monday. Hey. Thanks for bringing Nina home.
Don't worry.
She relies on you, you know. We both do.
I'm so sorry for your loss.
You've been a great comfort to me. Which is why this business with Ed Stewart is just so damn upsetting.
I saw the two of you talking.
He's paranoid. He thinks you're somehow plotting against him.
Yeah, why would I need to?
Which is exactly what I said. Oh, by the way, have you heard from Carrie lately?
No. Why'd you ask?
Oh, no reason. Occasions like this have a way of bringing back ghosts.
Yes. I hope you'll forgive me, but I can't stay for lunch.
Of course.
I trust you saw the news on Davenport?
I did.
It's an embarrassment to us. And costly.
Ed should have done his homework.
Clearly somebody did. You should have told me about Carrie. How do you expect me to protect you if you don't tell me the truth? Gord's not going to make you vice CEO.
Because of Carrie?
Because of a bipolar drug addict who, last I heard, is still legally your wife.
This is bullshit.
Jesus, Massimo, do you have any idea what it takes to be able to sit in this chair? What few mistakes you can make? Did you honestly imagine you could make a mistake like her?
This was a setup. Someone brought Carrie back to London.
You're being paranoid.
No, I'm not paranoid. Who told you about Carrie?
You said you were loyal.
Was it Ted?
Are you loyal?
Is he getting
Damn
the job?
It, are you loyal?
Devil speaking to me, whispering in my ear.